The following is paid programming.
It's time to talk taxes.
New friends, new opportunities, new partners. EG Tax.
It's Ask the Tax Lady with Esther Gullius and EG Tax on News Radio 930 WBEN. To reach Esther now, call 803-0930, toll free at 1-800-616-9236, and cell calls are free at *930. And now, live from the WBEN studios, it's Esther Gullius.
The last quarter of the year and the tax law changes and everything else, if you've been, and this week, you should have been inundated with letters from New York State, for those of you that got those letters. 803-0930, *930 on a cell phone. And Chris, Fabian, where is your sidekick?
I would say a sunnier place, but it's pretty sunny here. She's down in Florida right now, taking a little vacay.
That's cool. Do you miss her?
I do.
Does it feel weird to not have your partner with you?
Yes.
Well, we're talking about taxes. Now, wanted to tell everybody our tax school starting pretty soon, right?
That's right. In a little over a week, we got locations in Amherst, West Seneca, Lockport, Niagara Falls, and even the people who want to stay at home, you can do it at home in your PJs. We have a great interactive online class, too. if you want to learn taxes, I personally feel ours is the best course out there. We teach you everything. I mean, people are blown away by how much they learn.
We actually have a four-year program. I mean, yep. It's really, really a wonderful opportunity. So, and it's tax deductible. So if you just use it for your own use, which really will make you so much smarter, and a lot of these things that we are talking about every week, these are things we're teaching you in class. And it's the in-depth version, like all of the rules that support everything that we talk about. And it's absolutely a great thing. So if you want to go to our website at egtax.com, you basically click on the link about tax school.
That's right. And all the information's there. And, you know, and we didn't even say what a great opportunity for people to work during the cold time of year.
The winter.
Yeah, I just said
it's
cold.
It's hard to believe that winter really is only like, I mean, remember the October storm a couple years, 3-4 years ago?
Oh, yep.
It was October. What is this? Is this October?
It's October. It's now October.
Oh, my gosh. And they were saying it's so terrible because all the leaves are on the trees. The leaves are really on the trees.
That's right.
So if you think you might be interested in tax school, you can register online. Call us during the week. We'll get you registered. It's an adult learning opportunity. You'll be trained on computers. You don't have to know computers. It's all the things that helps you to go to do the calculations. But the important part is the law. And so it's the tax law that's so important. And I think during the tax season, you will be the most sought out person at a dinner party.
That's right. You know, there's people will say that in the beginning of class, that once people know you do taxes, you'll get asked questions and they'll like, oh, you're no way. And they'll come in like 4 weeks later going, okay, my neighbor just asked me this. What do I tell them?
All right, 803-0930, *930 on a cell phone. And wanted to also talk about this great app that EG Tax is launching. It's so cool because you can actually load your receipts that you've paid, and it'll keep track of everything for your business. It keeps track of your mileage if you're an outside salesperson. It's absolutely a great app.
Yep. You can do QuickBooks right through it. I mean, that's incredible. You know,
and it's free.
That's right. So when
are we launching?
I think hopefully in about a month from now, we'll be able to say it's out there, get it.
So this is so cool. You get the EG Tax app, and you got your QuickBooks right through EG Tax. And we can upload that to do your return.
Yep. And not to mention, with the app, we can keep you informed instantaneously of anything.
About changing the tax law,
yep.
Right?
Yep. Definitely. So.
All right. Let's talk about those New York State letters that came out this week.
Yeah. The ones that people who are 70 have to prove they're 70.
They're 60. 59
that they're over
and a half,
59
right?
and a half,
yeah.
Or that they, I love this one, that they have to prove that it's a New York State pension, so it's tax-free on the state.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's payable from New York State. Right?
They
payable
had to mail out
right.
100,000 in this area.
If you got that letter, don't pay it without checking with EG Tax. There's no charge if we didn't do the return, but you know, the first $20,000 of pension you receive, and an annuity and IRAs, if it's a non-state, federal, or municipality pension, is tax-free. 100% of your state, federal, or municipal pension is completely tax-free. So if you got that letter saying that you took a subtraction for a pension, don't pay it without talking to us, because basically they want proof that it was a government pension or proof that you're over the age of 59 and a half.
That's right. That's right. You know, it's a terrible thing that they're doing. But it was the same thing they did with the W-2s.
Right.
You know, anything they can do to try to make a little bit of extra money, whether it's right or wrong, they don't care. They're going to take your money if you give
right.
it to them.
So don't pay them. Yep. All right, let's go to the phones. We'll talk to Mr. Chris from Hamburg. Hey, Chris, how can we help you, sir?
Hi, Esther. I'm going to need your help for the first time in my life. I've always got my own taxes. I lost my wife in April to cancer.
Oh, my gosh. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, she was a teacher. And my question is, she died in April. Am I eligible to file the entire year as a married couple? That's question one. And two, the Social Security, which ended, and her state pension, will those automatically be sent to me with the statement so I'll be able to do my taxes?
Well, Chris, give him the good news. I mean, he needs some good news.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Definitely, the year of death, you can still file joint, okay? So that's going to help you on your tax return this year. And, yes, they will mail out the 1099s, the 1099-R and the 1099 SSA to the address on record. So as long as you don't move, you'll get them in the mail end of January, beginning of February.
And can I also ask you this? There are IRAs. I lost 52% of my income with the pensions because I didn't take out the survivors. But with as far as the IRAs that are transferred to me as a beneficiary, I didn't cash any of them, but they were just transferred to my name. None of that is taxed because I didn't cash them. Is that correct?
That's correct. But now here's the thing. Are children still living home with you, Chris?
No. My daughter's in her late 30s.
So maybe what you'd like to do is give us a call. We'll work out how much extra you might be able to take out this year or maybe next year to augment some of the income that you've lost, because it sounds like she was retired, right?
Well, see, yes. Well, see, what I'm fortunate, Esther, is I don't have to really tap into the IRAs.
Well, that's great.
The other question I have for you, I'm sorry to burden you with this, but any of the funerals, is there anything there that I might miss out that are write-offs, or is there anything?
Nothing for funerals.
No.
So, but again, it's worth a call. There's no charge, and we can kind of ask you some of these personal things that you don't want to talk to us over the air.
I will definitely.
Sorry to hear about it.
I've enjoyed your show for years, and I will definitely be contacting one.
All right. Thanks, Chris. God bless you.
Bless you.
All right. You know, that's so sad. To lose a spouse is just a horrible thing, you know.
Definitely. And, you know, and you are right with her passing away so early in the year, he may be able to adjust his withholding now so he doesn't give the government so much and wait for it come next year. He could put it in his pocket.
If her pension stopped, then the income goes down. So there's some tax planning that we can do for him. But again, it's something that should be done kind of one-on-one over the phone or in person, right?
Definitely.
I'm Esther Gullius, the tax lady, 803-0930, *930 in a cell phone. We're going to take a short break, and we'll be back on the other side with your questions. 1 week since you looked at me, cocked your head to the side and said I'm angry, 5 days since you laughed at me, saying hey, this is Esther Gullius, the tax lady from EG Tax, 803-0930, and we have Alex, who's been waiting a long time. Hi, Alex, how can we help you?
Yes, hi, Esther.
Hey.
First-time caller. Got a quick question for you. Can I borrow the money from my 401k plan and not to get penalized for it if I replenish it in the same year?
Okay. So the cool thing is about If the company allows a hardship withdrawal, you can borrow over up to a five-year repayment. You're repaying yourself plus interest. The borrowed money's not taxable, and that's a really good plan if you need the money. If this is the best place that you have looked to get money that you need. So, yes, as long as you're still with the company, you repay it within 5 years, you're paying yourself the principal and the interest, and it's not taxable. Good plan.
Now, what do they consider as a hardship? Do you know? Or?
Well, again, you have to talk to your employer because they have different criteria for hardship withdrawals, like medical situations, divorce, things of that nature. So talk to your HR people and tell them that you'd like to do a hardship with loan and see if they'll – the only way you can't get the money is if they won't let you take it.
Got it. Thanks.
Okay.
And make sure you say loan.
Right. Loan, not a withdrawal, but a loan.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you, sir. I'm Esther Gullius, the tax lady from EG Tax, 803-0930, 803-0930, star 930 on your cell phone. Every week we kind of have a topic, and I know we have people holding, but this my topic this week was little things mean a lot. And here's a bunch of little things that you can do. And if you don't, some of these things are five-minute changes that could make a gigantic change in your finances and in your taxes. First thing is, if you don't have a will, go do one Monday.
Tuesday. It's a holiday
well,
Monday.
Maybe the attorneys are working. Probably not. But I mean, yeah, because Monday.
Do it right away.
Because if you don't have a will, basically you would die without a will, and the state of New York would then determine where your assets go. So it's a really inexpensive thing to do, and it's a really good thing to do. Get a will.
Or update your will.
That's true. But getting a will in the first place is a really important
thing. Yes.
Secondly, gifting. If you're someone who's looking kind of at the sunny side of life and you're thinking about getting a little older and you're thinking, gee, what if I have to go into a nursing home? There's a five-year look back in order to have your nursing home expenses paid for through Medicaid. And so you want to make sure that you start your gifting well before the five-year period so that those assets aren't looked at in the event that you should have a nursing home in your future, right?
Yes.
And how much can you give per person per year without filing a gift tax return?
$14,000.
But you can actually give away your entire estate in 1 year as long as it's less than $5.4 million, right?
That's right. Because and you won't pay any tax.
Right. So the important thing is that you, as you get a little older, you think, gee, I would hate to lose all the money to the nursing home. Now, the other day, my own mom had to go into a nursing home for a short period of time before we put her in assisted living, and she was paying
$550 a day?
A day, yeah. She was paying like $18,000 for the month. So there's not too many months when it takes, you can get $18,000. And again, my mom had not, and she's in control of her assets, you know, because many times parents will say, oh, the kids just want my money. But that's the whole thing is what happens is you absolutely give away all of your money to the medical facility if you haven't used that five-year look back. So it's really important. And if you need help with that, we will help you.
Yes,
right?
Definitely.
Okay, let's go back to the phones. Margie from Akron. Hi, Marge. How can we help you? Marge?
Are you talking to me?
I am. Are you Marge?
Yes, I am.
Then it sounds like the right person.
So I'm calling because my husband and I are kind of in a dilemma. We were selling our longtime home in the town of Chickamauga and moving to a new build in Akron.
Okay.
The home that we were purchasing, they were both supposed to close around 9/1. We found out like a day or two before we were scheduled to close, the new buyers of our property in Chickamauga decided to back out. So now we have the money used to purchase the new home was, of course, from the old home. My husband's retired. I'm 69, but I'm still working. So the best plan that our financial advisor came up with to, so that we could get this immediate need is to take the money out of our IRAs so that we wouldn't have to pay any surrender charges or anything as long as we would get the money back within 60 days, which I don't know if that's going to happen. But the total was $122,000.
Oh, my God.
That's going to hit.
Have you done this yet, Marge?
Yes.
Okay.
So we,
how long ago did you take the money out?
9/6, so we have to close by 11/6, and our house.
Okay, but you see,
new buyers, but I don't know if they're going to close in time.
All right, so you do have new buyers.
Yes, I've talked to the lawyer, talked to the real estate agent, and said it's imperative this house that we get the check in hand by November 6th, so we don't get penalized, you know, or not penalized, but this is not considered as income.
Okay, so here's the whole thing. You have to roll that money back within 60 days back into your pension, into your IRA,
right,
or the whole $122,000 is taxable. Now, if you're in a lower tax bracket, you're going to pay taxes about $15,000, with the state of New York about $20,000. So that's a lot of taxes you would end up paying if you don't roll that back in time. You need to strategize and figure out where the heck you're going to get $122,000 to put back into your IRAs so that you're not stuck with that income on your tax return. That would be the most important thing. Is there any other assets you have? Do you have stocks or anything?
Can you take a loan out against the new house?
Not that much. It's all like piddly anny stuff. Nothing is, you know, a big fail.
How much is the new house worth?
$352,000.
Okay, so there's no mortgage on the new house?
Yes, there is.
There is.
$160,000.
All right. So would they do you a home equity credit line, a home equity line, so you can get $122,000 out and pay it off, and then when the house closes, you can pay off the home equity?
I never thought of it because I didn't think that they would. Okay, so I guess we'd go to the bank. That would be our next thing to
do. Do you? What bank are you dealing with?
Bank of Akron.
Okay, they're a small bank. Usually they understand, bring your purchase papers on the house you're selling and see if they won't do a home equity credit line so that you can pay off that withdrawal from the IRA, put the money back in the IRA. That'll save you like $20,000 in taxes. And then as soon as the house sells, pay that off.
Yep, okay.
All right.
Wish I could do it Monday, but I guess I'll do it Tuesday.
There you go. If you need help, call us. Okay, Margie? Yeah.
And I'm looking to kind of be proactive. Could we come into the office and maybe talk to somebody about what to do?
You can, and there's no charge. So
okay.
Make sure you do it, okay?
And you can call us Monday. We're going to be open.
Oh, you will?
Yep.
And I've been listening for your number, but I haven't heard it.
632-7886.
7886. Okay, thanks.
Okay, Margie. Hope we saved you $20,000.
I'm hoping too. I wanted to retire in January, so okay.
Well, I mean, you know, there's a lot of options. Like, do you have a pension plan at work?
It's only worth 10.
Okay, but you see, the whole thing is, does your husband have a pension? No.
Yes, he does, a state pension, and
he can't borrow against it, right?
Oh, hello.
Hello.
I'm still here.
She's thinking. See, but here's the whole thing. That's what we're going to do is we're going to find out if we can get this money from other sources. But I got to believe the Bank of Akron, one of the wonderful things about dealing with a local bank is they have a lot more autonomy because the larger banks have to go kick it upstairs. And there's a lot of heart with a local bank. So I'm hoping that they'll come.
We're aware of everything from the get-go. So they're
okay.
Wonderful.
All right, sweetie pie. Thank you. Good luck. I'm Esther Golias, the tax lady, 803-0930, *930 on a cell phone. Let's talk to Barbie. Barbie from Hamburg. Hi, Barb.
Bill from Rochester first,
oh,
sorry.
Oh, Bill from Rochester. Hey, Bill, how you doing?
Hey, how you doing, Esther?
Good. What can we do for you, sir?
I'm listening from Rochester to the Buffalo station, and sometimes it doesn't come in quite clearly. But did you mention something about New York State tax? $20,000
income
exclusion.
Yep. All right. So if you're over the age of 59 and a half, the first $20,000 in pension you receive.
And I'm a federal government.
Then 100% of your pension is tax-free on New York State. Yes.
And they sent me a recent thing in the mail, says proposed audit change. And I can't tell. I got to find my. This is for 2014.
Yep, right. That's the letter they're mailing out.
That's the letter they're mailing out, and they're basically making you pay taxes on something that's tax-free. So all you have to do is call us on Monday, send us over that letter. We'll have proof that you're a New York State retiree. We'll send a letter, and it'll all be cleared up.
I'm not a New York State retiree. I'm a
federal
government. Federal retiree.
Yeah. Do you have an office in Rochester?
We don't. We had one, we had a franchise who just kind of dropped out. So we don't have an office in Rochester, but we're working our way back to you, babe. We're coming that way.
So I'd have to come to you in Buffalo?
No, actually, all you have to do is fax it, mail it, email it. You don't have to come to Buffalo. We'll take care of it over the internet.
Do you need my tax form for 2014?
We need your driver's license and your 1099s.
Yeah, and fax us the letter so we can respond to that letter. Okay?
Okay, thank you.
All right, thank you, sir. I'm Esther Gullius, the tax lady, 803-0930, 803-0930, star 930 on your cell phone. And we're going to take a short break for the news, and we'll be back with your questions and more little things that you should do to fix your finances. Thanks for listening. We'll be right back. That's how we feel. There's nothing wide enough to keep us from getting to you. I'm Esther Golias, the tax lady, 803-0930, star 930 on your cell phone. We're kind of talking about little things can mean a lot. And one of the things is gifting your home. People, Chris, and you can verify this, people have a tendency to say, we need to go to the attorney and change the title of the house, because they're worried about losing it in the event of a nursing home, right?
Right.
But what's the best way for a parent to gift their home to their child and still retain that stepped-up basis so that the kid doesn't have to pay the taxes?
That would be a life estate.
So basically, they go to the attorney and say, we want to do a life estate as opposed to a full-out gift, right?
That's right. That's right.
And so then when the child gets the house, they get what's called a stepped-up basis. They get what the fair market value would have been at the date of the death of the parent. And so if the parent died when the house was worth $200,000, they sell it for $200,000, there's no gain. Had the parent paid $50,000, even though it was worth $200,000 when they passed away, if they had given the whole title to the kid back whenever, then the kid ends up with $150,000 gain. So it's really important. And what if somebody already gifted their house to their kid? What can they do?
The child can re-gift it back.
Right. Give it back and then do a life estate.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
So these are little things. Little things mean a lot. The other thing is life insurance. When you inherit life insurance on a decedent, is that taxable to you?
No, it's not.
All right, so using life insurance as a tool would mean that your heirs would inherit the money at no cost. And especially on term life policy, it ensures the fact that your heirs are going to get money and it's going to be tax-free. And that's an easy thing to do. And if you don't have life insurance and you know you're wondering what to do, take a look at the term life feature, and it would be tax-free to your beneficiaries. And speaking of beneficiaries, if you don't have beneficiaries listed on your IRAs or your annuities or your pension, is that good or bad?
Oh, that's just as bad as not having a will.
Right. So that's something somebody should do. Tuesday, add your beneficiaries to those policies so that it gives the beneficiaries flexibility. You want to explain what would happen if they have a beneficiary versus no beneficiary, Chris?
Sure. If they have a beneficiary, then the money goes right to the beneficiary without going through the estate. So that saves a whole bunch of time, aggravation. But if it goes without any beneficiary, then the estate receives the money, pays taxes at a much, much, much higher rate very fast that rate goes up. So you're talking about you could, you know, if you have $50,000 in there, it could save you about $10,000 by just listing the beneficiaries by not then having the not having the beneficiaries.
Right, and then the other thing is when you have a beneficiary, there ends up they can either take the full thing, they can do it over 5 years, or they can annuitize it, right?
Right.
And so that gives the beneficiary flexibility as far as what's going to be taxable. So that's another benefit. Okay, let's go back to the phones, and we're going to Barb, who has been waiting and waiting. Hey, Barb, this is Esther Goulias. How can we help you?
Yes. Hi. My husband just had an open heart surgery, so we have quite a bit of medical.
Okay.
I was wondering if that can be deductible and how much.
Okay, so tell me this, Barb. Do you and your husband file a tax return?
Yes.
You do. Okay, how much do you think that you've paid out of pocket for all medical this year, your health insurance, the medical expenses, co-pays, pension, prescriptions, dentist, everything this year out of pocket?
That I don't know.
Do you have a ballpark?
I really don't know.
What, $10, $100?
$2,000.
$8,000,
$10,000? It's about $300 something a month.
So that's $3,600 a year. No more than the $3,600 a year?
For a month.
$300 a month is $3,600 in the year.
Plus, we have medications and doctor's appointments.
So what would you think that you paid out of pocket last year? $10,000? Well, let's just use that as an example. So, what source of income do you and your husband have besides Social Security?
Pension.
And how high is that pension?
It's about three and a half, four and a half.
A month or a year?
A month.
So, like $4,000 a month?
Yeah.
So that's $48,000, and that is not your Social Security, correct?
Right.
Okay, so assuming that her income then would be maybe $60,000 with the Social Security, would you agree with that, Chris?
Correct.
So her floor then would be
$6,000.
So she ended up with a $4,000 medical deduction if the itemized deductions are still in play and they don't change the tax law. So right now, one of the things they're proposing is that medical bills would not be deductible,
property taxes, yeah, New York State taxes.
Property taxes would not be deductible, sales taxes would not be deductible, neither would any other type of investment interest, expenses you pay for an attorney for taxable income, union dues, things that if you're an employee business expenses, all those would be eliminated. So if the tax law stays the same, yes, Barbara, you'd be able to deduct it. If the tax law changes, no, you won't.
Oh, brother.
So keep staying tuned. We will let you know. But here's the important thing. If they don't change the tax law, make sure that you put as much in your medical as you possibly can this year so that you can take the biggest bang for your buck, because they're going to make you reduce your itemized deduction, your medical deduction by 10% of your adjusted gross income. So you want to make sure that you have as much as possible in your medical expenses, okay?
Yes.
Okay, sweetie. If you need help, you make sure you call us, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. I'm Esther Goulias, the tax lady, 8030930, 8030930, star 930 on a cell phone. Okay.
Ed, hold on. We had someone texted in asking what office we have open to discuss his Uber business or her Uber business.
Our corporate office is open this time of year, 2475 Niagara Falls Boulevard, Amherst, right?
Yep.
9 to 5, Monday through Friday. And, of course, pretty soon we'll be open at all of our offices 9 to 9. But I know I shouldn't say that. All right. Other things you can do, an easy thing, go down to HR and set up a pension plan.
That's right. If they're offering
something to do on Tuesday or Monday, if you're working Monday, go down to HR and set up a pension.
Right, right. Because especially if they're doing a match and if you're not contributing, you're throwing away free money.
Throwing away money.
Yep.
Refinance your house. There are people that are have mortgages over, that are over 5% interest that they're paying, and they have not refinanced because they don't want to be bothered. What you're doing is you're giving the bank a windfall. You're giving them interest that they're not entitled to. And again, if you need help with that, you can call EG Tax. Don't take money out of your pension or your IRA to pay bills. Why would that be true, Chris?
Oh, well, if you're under 59 and a half, especially, because it not only would count as income, so that means you're paying tax on it, but you would also get hit with a 10% penalty.
Right. And just like we were helping that lady who took the $122,000 out of her IRA to buy her house, there are things that you can do. There are ways to get around if you need to pay, if you need to pay credit cards and things. You may be looking at a bankruptcy. It's actually better in many cases to do a bankruptcy than it is to take the money out of your pension plan. And that's something that we're very happy to help you with at EG Tax. Give us a call at 632-7886 or go to our website and we will help you.
That's right.
Right?
Yes.
Okay. I'm Esther Gullius, the tax lady, 8030930, 8030930, star 930 in a cell phone. Okay. Other things you can do. Easy thing. Donate appreciated assets to charity. If you're an itemizer and you have stock that maybe you paid $10 a share for, but you really want to give money to charity, you're a philanthropist, and let's say it's now trading at $1,000 a share. Well, if you sell it, you're going to have a gigantic capital gain, right?
That's right.
But if you donate that appreciated property to charity because you want to give to charity anyway, is any of that gain taxable?
No.
No. And that's just really all it is like changing the way you think. So, and again, before you do something, or if you want EG Tax to go over all your stuff, come in. There's no charge, right?
That's right.
All right. The other one, my little pet peeve, is think about taking money out of your Social Security at age 62.
Start taking your Social Security.
All right, and there are limitations if you're working, but let's assume that you're retired and you're thinking of waiting to age 70. Well, if you start collecting at age 62, and let's say you're getting $1,500 a month, that means that you're going to get $18,000 a year. If you wait those 8 years to collect, you've lost $144,000 in income, right? $18,000 times 8 years, $144,000. Even though they're going to increase your monthly income to $2,340, it's still going to take 14.29 years to break even. So at the age of 84, you break even. Until then, you're behind the eight ball. So think about collecting at age 62. And the other thing is, we really never know that there will be Social Security in the future or how they're going to tax it.
Yep, right? Yep. And also, normally when someone's around 84, 85, they're worried about, how do I get rid of my money? And now they're getting more money, you know.
That's exactly right. I'm Esther Gullius, the tax lady, 8030930, 8030930, star 930 on your cell phone. I know we have callers waiting. We're going to take a short break, and we'll be back on the other side with your question. Esther Gullius, the tax lady from EG Tax, 8030930, star 930 on his cell phone. I know we got Joe and Mary hanging here. I'll be right with you, Joe. Another thing you can do is write up a list so your heirs know what you have and where it is. Right?
Yep, yep.
I mean, that's really important because, you know, many times people find lost money. that the state is holding, because nobody let anybody know about all of their assets. And after they pass, it goes on to the state, and the state puts it into that lost money fund. So do yourself a favor. Sit down tomorrow and make up a list for your heirs and put it in a safe place for them so that they would know upon your passing what your assets are and where they are, and maybe what your some of your passwords are.
Right? And yeah, also, you know, I've seen it too, where people are hiding a coin collection in the house, different things, you know. Let them know if there's something hidden inside your house, because I mean, could you imagine? I mean, how many times you hear someone bought a house and they found this, you know?
My dad used to hide money in the rafters, and my brother was looking for hockey, was playing hockey, and he was looking for hockey socks, and he said, "Oh, look at, there's some hockey socks up in the rafters," and he pulled it down, and it was my dad's stash. And he thought, "Wow, this is really great." My mother says, "Put it back, Tom. Your dad's gonna kill you." Anyway, let's go back to the phones. We got Joe, who's been hanging. Mr. Joe, how can we help you, sir? Joe. Hello, Joe.
Joe.
Did we lose Joe?
Well, let's put him on hold. And
all right, we'll go back to Mary in Akron. Hey, Mary.
Hello.
Hey, Mary, how can we help you, dear?
Well, two things. I know you said we could do the life estate. Last week I heard something else about buying a home with your child, and you could have the with the something written in that you could live there as long as you lived.
Well, that's the life estate.
That's a life.
So basically what you're in a life estate, you get to, you have the control of the assets. The property taxes still come to you based upon your whatever your tax your property taxes would be. You, everything is the same. The difference is you retain a life estate for as long as you want to live there, but the child then upon your death, you would get a stepped up basis so they don't have to pay the taxes when they sell the house at a gain.
Okay. Now,
in most situations.
They also told me that I have two sons, so I could buy. We're not retired yet, but I could buy a house with one in South Carolina and one in and then up in New York State.
Okay.
Well,
Right. Go on, Chris.
Yep. You can only do the life estate on your primary residence.
Okay. Just on the primary.
Yep.
Right.
Okay. And how does that work as far as taxes, as income taxes and stuff like that? How do we pay that?
Well, see, there is nothing. When you're gifting, you're doing a life estate, there's nothing that nothing that is reported to the Internal Revenue Service until the ultimate sale. So there's nothing that the IRS is aware of.
Okay.
Okay, so that's just between you, your heirs, and the attorney.
Okay. All right.
Okay?
So that has to be written up by an attorney. And
absolutely.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you, dear.
Bye-bye.
Okay, and we'll go back to the phones. Did Joe come back, or are we just looking
let's
at Dave?
See. Joe? Joe.
Joe left. Okay, let's do Dave from Buffalo. Hey, Dave.
Uh-oh. That might have been me. Hold on. There we go. Dave.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Good.
Fat fingers. What can I say?
I got them, too. Let me ask you a question. The tax laws, they're going to be retroactive for this year, correct?
Not necessarily. I mean, right now, you're dealing with, you know what Congress is like. You don't know what you're dealing with. So we don't know what they're going to do, whether they're going to even pass a tax law change. They are saying that maybe it's going to be retroactive, and that's part of what we'll do. As soon as we know, we will let you know.
Okay. As it stands, I heard that the property tax write-off is going to be available, correct?
No. No, no. That's one of the things they're getting rid of, is the property taxes, and especially in New York State, that's a big deal. But then again, I heard, you know, through the grapevine that they're now saying you can choose between your property taxes as the deduction or your mortgage interest. So right now, it'll be interesting to see what'll happen, because you have all these politicians who are hoping to get reelected. And from what I understand, there's like 73 politicians that are in high tax states who will definitely have a very negative thing to happen to their taxpayers if this present tax law goes into effect, plus parents, people with children. Okay? But we will keep you abreast as soon as it happens, Dave.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
All right. Thanks. You know, it's interesting. I just had somebody that texted me who said it would be great if if parents would let their children know what their assets are. But this particular person says, my mother won't even let me know where the will is. So if mom is listening and dad are listening, you have to share that with your children. It's a horrible thing. In the event of your death, untimely or timely, that your heirs would not know where the will is, who wrote the will, where the assets are, because what happens is if there's assets that they don't know about, it goes to the state of New York.
That's right.
Hello.
Yep.
Okay. And let's go back to the phones, and we have Dennis, right?
Yep.
Hey, Dennis, how can we help you?
Yes, I was curious. We don't live in New York State, but I listen to your show pretty weekly.
Yeah.
And on the five-year look back, is that a federal law or is it a state law?
That's a New York State Medicaid law. But I will tell you, it looks like most states have some type of phase-in of that same situation. So if you're in another state, what I would do is check with the attorney and see what the Medicaid restriction is in your particular state. But New York State is very friendly to people on Medicaid, and if they pre-plan their estate, they can actually go on Medicaid in many situations for the nursing home.
I see. Okay. Well, that was pretty much the answer I needed. Now, you have an office out here in Phoenix, right?
We do. We do. Well, not in Phoenix. We're in
Prescott Valley. Prescott
Valley. Don't say Prescott. It's Prescott. Oh. Prescott Valley.
And it is 5 years in Arizona as well.
Okay, great. 5 years in Arizona as well.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome, sir. One thing about us, if we don't know, we will find out.
That's right.
Isn't that the truth?
That's right.
And not that taxes aren't difficult, but I will tell you, if we don't know, we will find out. As a matter of fact, you have a situation right now that a guy might lose a $200,000 refund, right?
That's right. That's right. And it's all depending on whether he filed an extension for his 2013 tax return.
Right. Right. Otherwise, he's going to, because if you don't timely file your return within 3 years of the due date of the return plus extensions, then you would lose your refund. And this particular guy has a $200,000 refund. And we're trying to pull a rabbit out of a hat for him. Okay, let's go back to the phones. We got Joe. Joe is back. Joe, where did you go?
I was trying to talk to you, but it just wasn't working out.
What can we help you with, sir?
Getting back to gifting of a home to children. What happens with the veterans' benefits that you get for tax exemption?
Well, as far as I know, on a life estate, everything stays the same. The same star rebates stay the same and everything. So what I'd suggest you do is call your attorney and double check to make sure that is correct with your VA benefits. But it really is the best thing to do as you're anticipating aging. If you're not somebody that wants to be a private pay patient in a nursing home, it's a really important thing to do.
I know my mother still gets those benefits in her houses in a life estate.
You're talking about the tax exemptions?
Right.
5%?
Yep.
Right. But again, never just take what we say. Double check it against what your attorney says, okay?
And you call that a life estate?
A life estate, right.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Okay, let's see. A couple other things you should do right away on Monday or Tuesday. If you're somebody that doesn't pay taxes and you have an IRA because you're under the minimum filing requirement and you have an IRA and you haven't been taking the money out, take the money out up to the place where you'd pay taxes. Take that out. It's going to be tax-free. Right, Chris?
That's right. I mean, come on. I'm saving it. What? So then when you really need it, you have to pay taxes. Take a little out each year.
Right.
Put it away, and you'll have a nice little
nest egg. Exactly. If you're somebody that's thinking about selling your home, do you know that the first $250,000 of gain or $500,000 of gain, if you're married filing a joint return, $250,000 if you're single, is completely tax-free on the sale of your personal
residence?
And
you don't have to purchase another one.
Right. So that's another thing. The other thing is not having insurance on your valuable assets. Let's say you have some lovely jewelry and you've never had it appraised and you have no insurance on it. Go get it insured. It's not very expensive, but it's really important. I will tell you, for those people that have been impacted by some of the disasters they are really happy that they had insurance.
And fight, you know, if you feel you're not getting the right amount, question your insurance company.
That's exactly right, because a friend of mine who has a house in the Keys almost lost it. Their boat and everything was totaled, and their car was totaled. So the insurance company called and said to her, we're going to send you a check for $26,000. And she said, gee whiz, that was a F-350, whatever, really fancy schmancy car. So they said, she said, I paid $56,000 for it. The insurance company said, oh, we just have it down as a $150. So they sent her $37,000. You know, I mean, that's a big difference.
That's
big
huge.
Difference, yep. Right? So, and the other thing is, if you got kids going to college this fall, try not to have them go into debt. Going into debt can be a noose around your neck when you get out of college. You got to pay that back, and it can ruin your credit, which means you're going to pay more in insurance. Your FICO score goes down. You're going to pay more for a mortgage. And the other thing is, get a second opinion on most everything. If you hear something and it doesn't line up, look it. Get a second opinion, and I will tell you, EG Tax is a great place to get a second opinion because our second opinions are absolutely at no charge. And check your credit. You can download your credit score. There's no charge. Look at it and see if somebody's got credit in your name and it's not your credit. There are all kinds of things you should do, and make yourself a note that you're going to do it. And if you need a list of what I got, well, we can make it available to you by calling our office at 632-7886. Until next week, I'm Esther Golias, the Tax Lady, with Christopher Fabian. And if you need us during the week, you can visit us at our corporate headquarters or visit us online at egtax.com. Until next week, I'm Esther Golias, the Tax Lady, with Christopher Fabian. Have a great week. God bless. Bye-bye.